This your life. You do what you want to do. Nobody has control over it, whether they like it or not. They're gonna have to either just go take it for what it is, because this is your life. You get one life to live, you guys. One life. Pretties, welcome back to Pretty Incorporated, where we are loving on ourselves, shining our light, and just being all things great. I am Germany, and on today, I'm bringing you just a little talk. I just wanted to talk about something for myself going forward with the new year, about some things, and so just my word for the year. Every year, I feel like I try to look for, you know, God, what is it that you want me to do? What is it that I'm supposed to do? What is it that I am focusing on in the year? And so the word that was been given to me is being intentional, or just intentional. And with that comes having focus, really knowing what you want, really knowing what it is you want to do, and really sitting and say, I'm going to do these things to get there, being really focused. And so I found an article, and I definitely will link it in the description box so you all can get a, it just touched me so. And it was just like saying, being intentional is about being bringing that commitment, focus, and attention to something that is important to you. If you want to be intentional with your everyday life, you need to get upfront about what you want to achieve and take action on achieving them. And so I say that because I am definitely in that place where I am learning to say, Lord, what is it that I want? What is it that I want to do? How am I going to get myself from point A to point B and still achieve everything without feeling like I have burnt myself out, without feeling like I'm done with it, without feeling like I'm giving up, without saying, Lord, it's not going the way I thought it was going to go. It's not growing like I wanted it to grow, you know. So how do I take those steps to say, you know what, I'm going to be intentional about what it is I want. I'm going to write down what it is I want. So me, my plan is to, my three focus, I have three things that I'm focusing on, and I'm writing down how can I be consistent and make baby steps to get all of those things accomplished. And so that is something that you can do, being intentional about your health, for instance. Okay, starting out with the small things. I'm gonna drink this amount of water, you know, every day, or until I can build up to this. So maybe it's one bottle of water today, or maybe it's two bottles of water in a week, or, you know, trying to just build up, you know, the things, to start small and see that consistency with it. And that's one thing I'm learning, that consistency is key. And so that is something I'm also working on, is being consistent and knowing that. And it's just saying that once you know what you want, you start achieving those things, those things become bigger and better for yourself, your business, and for your life. You start to really see yourself in a different light. You start to know that I am capable of it. You find confidence in yourself, meaning say, I can get there. I know I can. I could do just like someone else. And it's like, you don't want to be anyone else. You want to be just you. You want to be you for you, and you want to do what it is that you are supposed to be doing. And so that is my whole thing about it, is being intentional and just saying that I can achieve whatever it is I want to. It's causing me to say, you know what, stop giving up on yourself. Stop letting doubt and things set in. Start really knowing to say, this is your lane. You create a lane for yourself. If you feel like you're throwing yourself into a world full of things, it's all right, because God is going to open a way for you in your space. You just got to keep going. One day, somebody, like for me, and I'll be honest, YouTube. My YouTube, y'all, I just wanted to do YouTube in 2015. I know for sure. I was watching videos, and especially when I started having my daughter, I was like, oh, I could do like a mommy thing, but I didn't do it. And it was because I was just like, oh, I'm not good enough. No, I don't fit the bit. You know, I don't fit the thing. And so I don't have to. You know, it was just so many things going on at that time. But I'm putting myself right here, right now, at a space to say, you know what? I can still do it, even with the things that life throws at me. I'm still capable of it. I can, if other people who started out as just, they're even still regular people, can do it, so can I. That's my mentality. It's never a jealous thing. It's like, man, if they can do it, so can I. Like, there's so many opportunities out here for us to do things. And it's like, I'm going to create that space for me. And so I'm creating a space where I show women this is me. This is the body I'm living with. This is who I am. These are the things I'm learning in life. These are the things I love that I want to share to help you along your journey. Like, it is so many things that I want to share. And so that is just where I'm at right now with it. And just really being just positive about things. That's the number one thing. You have to learn to be positive while you're trying to create, be intentional. Because if you're negative, you are not going to achieve anything if you are negative. So that is just no way to be. And so it also says, what does it mean to be intentional? It means basically, again, taking a clear purpose, taking action, thoughts, and feelings that are most important to you. Again, learning to be intentional means choosing to take actions on the things that are important to you. Living with intention means you consciously choose to create the life you want rather than having other people dictate your feelings and actions. That hit home for me because I felt like I lived a life for other people. Like the idea I had set for myself and what I felt like had been thrown on me unknowingly as a kid. And like when things happened in my life, I was just like, oh my God, how would this make my mom look, my family look, you know, how would this make them look? And so it was just like, I had to realize and say, damn, this is your life. You do what you want to do. Nobody has control over it. Whether they like it or not, they're going to have to either just go take it for what it is. Because this is your life. You get one life to live, you guys. One life. And you don't want nobody running your life. And that was my thing. And also me just going with the flow of life. Whatever life throwed at me, I was like, okay, I guess that's what I'm doing. Okay, I guess that's what I'm doing. Absolutely not. That is just not the case for me anymore. That is not what I'm going to do for my life. That is absolutely not it. I'm no longer allowing people or things to dictate how I move in my life. This mine. The only person that got some control is that's God. That's the only one that controlled me. And only me and him decide what's the move. And I say, okay, God, I'm going to go. Now, some stuff we always don't like what he say, but you have to follow because you don't know what it is he has planned for you. And I don't know what it is he has planned for me. All I know is I listen to what he tells me and I just say, I'm going to go with it. And we're going to put our authentic selves out there to do what it is he said he wants to do. So my thing for you is find out what it is you want to do. Find out what it is you want your life to be like and look like and feel like and who you want to be like and how they operate. What's their day-to-day activity? What is his or her day-to-day things that she likes to do? How do they go about life? Because once I made a decision on my life, it's like this ball is lit up inside of me, and every time something bad happens, I go back to that place and it just lights up and it puts me back centered to where I'm supposed to be. And that's laser focused on what God has told me and to not let anything stray me away from what it is my purpose in life. And so I just encourage you all to really find out what it is that you want to do with your life. Really sit down, especially with the new year coming. We are doing vision boards and things like that. I know I am. So get out your printer, newspaper, magazines, whatever you're going to use and create. Whether if you draw. If you write. You don't have to have pictures, but do what it is that you want to see and create in the life that you want. Because that's my whole idea. And I'm super excited for when I get ready to do mine, because God is showing me so much and just telling me so many things. And so I'm super hyped when it comes to 2022, me and what things I have coming up. And I just cannot wait to just keep moving in my purpose and being okay with, I am right here right now, but this is not my end all be all. I get to change my narrative any day of the week, and I'm beginning to change my narrative of my life. So I hope you guys and girls really, you know, resonate with that. Please, I encourage you all to just do what it is that you want to do. Create your life. Love on yourself. Know if you only get one life to live, and being miserable and unhappy is not it. So I thank you, Pretties, for watching. Please don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Join the Pretty family, because we are only getting bigger from here. And I will see you girls in the next video.